Hello everyone, this is Jeff of Taofledermaus. Today we have an experiment that I call the hydraulic expansion bullet. Basically all I did, I took a 9mm full metal jacket bullet and carefully drilled a deep pocket into it, like a really deep hollow point. I filled that full of a liquid, in this case red dye, and then I sealed it with epoxy. The idea is to create a hydroshock condition inside the bullet, causing it to expand much more than a normal hollow point. Today's shooter is Nick, and he'll be shooting these through the Chiapa M19 9mm carbine. Okay, it's really called Chiapa, but Chiapa is much more fitting because it's such a cheapo gun. First shot is at a steel plate. Now, the reason I picked a steel plate was I was expecting this to leave a big red stain on it, but that just didn't happen, so let's find another target. Okay, these are clear ballistic gel gummy bears. We didn't see anything exciting happen here, otherwise we would have shot it with a normal, unmodified ball round. So this probably isn't the right target yet.
You gonna be shooting out of a Glock this time?
Glock 19 Gen 4.
And once again, we didn't see anything odd happening, which is a good thing because I only had one watermelon, but we wanted to show you what it looked like shot out of a handgun. Next up is the Bat 19 5-pound gummy bear. Let's see how this works. The Bat 19 gummy bears are very tough and are probably about 5 times denser or thicker than ballistic gel. And you can see there's a big red spot where that bullet impacts. As we watch this again, watch the trail of red mist coming off the bullet. It must have had a tiny pinhole in it, and it leaked some of that red dye out. But I thought that was still pretty interesting. Now let's compare it to an unmodified bullet. We definitely found the right target this time. You'll notice that the unmodified bullet, the full metal jacket bullet, had no problem just going right through that gummy bear, and it didn't even knock it over. It went through so cleanly. Okay, let's see what the hydraulic bullet did to this gummy bear. He hit it at a kind of a thinner area of the gummy bear, yet the bullet did not pass through at all. It pretty much exploded and fragmented inside there, and there is a large amount of red dye in there. Let's start pulling some of the pieces out and see what we've got. Now once I had all the pieces out, I cleaned them up, and this is what I've got. Lots of unrecognizable fragments. Little pieces of lead and copper jacketing. Pretty interesting experiment. I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching.